be feeding a big food to them. But we do feed both these tunas, those very fast bullet-shaped fish, and those beautiful mahi-mahi up on top of, you see the big male with the square forehead right at the top there, those two slightly smaller females. They eat on different days of the week, but we keep them well enough fed that they probably won't go after our sardines. Now the sardines, sometimes they come up all at once. Sometimes it takes a little bit of throwing a little more food in the water to get them interested. In the meantime, you can see that ocean sunfish is right at the surface there. Here come our sardines now. Dropped into the water that looks sort of like a pink cloud. Yeah, that is a lot of sardines. Now, let me tell you, we have a couple of tunas that are new to this exhibit. They haven't gotten word yet that, you know, lunch is provided. They don't have to go after it. So maybe instead of 18,000 sardines, maybe we should say 17,998 of us. Yeah. Watch how these sardines move around. They're really coordinated in a big school. There's actually still several hundred of them down on the bottom as well. And you can see they move almost as one organism as they move around. Those big schools move up and down really dramatically. Yeah. Now here's something you can try. The reason that sardines move in these big tight schools like this is for safety. It helps them